Hello and welcome back to Scale Me Down. One of our viewers, Alan Knights, asked how we produce our airbrush stencils. So in this episode, we're going to custom airbrush paint this T-Rex 450 canopy using some homemade stencils. Remember to like and subscribe to support the channel. For this project, I molded my own canopy. And that's because the original didn't fit that well, particularly with this 4S setup. And so to do that, I made a 3D sculpture, which I could then FDM print and mold directly, which I then primered, wet sanded, surfaced and waxed, etc. Once I produced this epoxy glass part from that mold, I then also had to sand the seams flush and fill, prime and sand until the surface is perfect. And that's because the final finish is directly affected by the surface preparation. I'm also now wearing gloves, or at least we'll wash our hands regularly so we don't get finger marks, which will also directly affect the paint. Now let's make our multi-layered alien style stencils. Inspiration here comes from H.R. Giger's original work and also this drawing by pop culture artist Phil Bourne. Here I'm making a sketch of the basic shapes over the top of this drawing. I'm not trying to replicate the drawing here, I'm just using it as inspiration, keeping the shapes simple. Any vector drawing package will do for this, and CorelDRAW is a popular choice. Here I'm using Inkscape, which is free. Using the polygon tool, we click to add editable nodes. But there are also some useful tools that can add or subtract geometry. Once we have our shapes, we can output them to the Craft Robo vinyl cutting plotter onto some masking film. Unlike a traditional plotter that uses a pen, this machine has a little knife that it moves back and forth and up and down. And meanwhile, the vinyl, which is stuck to a gummed carrier sheet, is moved in and out, and these motions are used to cut out the vinyl stencils. We can, of course, make our stencils from anything. However, it is handy to use a material that's both clear, so we can see what we're doing for alignment, and also self-adhesive to free our hands up. And my go-to is this matte artist's Friskit film. It's matte, so you can draw on it with a pencil if necessary. It doesn't stretch, it's low tack, and it doesn't leave a residue. With the stencils cut out, let's move on to the paint. And I'm using my Iwata Eclipse airbrush for this project, along with Tamiya paints. I've strapped a camera here to the airbrush to give you a better view. I've blocked out the large areas of neon pink with thin coats from a rattle can. The bright colour should make it easier to see at distance. I'm adding the white fade or glow with the airbrush, as I've more control than I do with the rattle can. We can remove the positive stencil to reveal the outline. We can also use the negative parts of the sheet that we cut out from, plus combinations of different stencil layers to isolate the part of the drawing that we're working on. Here I'm sketching into the unmasked area using a colour called Black Green, and I'm doing it freehand, using the stencils just as a sketch. Let's choose our light source to inform us where the highlights and shading should go. We can also make use of other everyday items to make interesting textures, such as this wood screw. For finer details, we can produce thinner lines by removing the nozzle guide to get closer to the work.
I find that working in a logical fashion with the stencil layers helps to prevent unwanted overspray in other parts of your painting. It's also really helpful to bring on both sides of the canopy together, adding details in each step to allow drying time. Now I'm adding a couple of layers of transparent candy black. You should still see the detail through this paint, but it should provide a bit of contrast for the subsequent highlights. As someone is bound to ask, this is how I made the landing gear. I drew this 3D sculpture in Mesh Mixer that I then printed on our FDM printer. After filling, priming and sanding, I sprayed the legs matte black. Once dry, I added white highlights with the airbrush and with some dry brushing. Then they got several coats of transparent candy black. Meanwhile, back to the canopy where I wanted to make some alterations to the artwork. I think the creature's neck looks too spindly, so I want to add the large round shoulder blade details. And I also think that the design looks a bit too dark, so we'll continue to add some more white highlights. In addition to reusing some of our earlier stencils, I'm also using some household items, such as the inside of this roll of tape. In the past, I've used net onion bags or ladies' fishnet tights to produce a scaly skin texture. Just a case of experimenting and having fun with your airbrushing. Let's tighten up some of those white highlights and let's tidy up the teeth. I'm making a simple stencil by slicing two crossed lines into a piece of paper to add some simple stars to our alien sky. I also used this project to try out this acrylic ink for the first time, adding some pink reflections from the sky into some of the highlights. And once all the paint was completely dry, I protected the artwork with several layers of clear coat. And now the finished canopy. Let's fit it to the helicopter and see how it looks. I had fun making this canopy and I hope you enjoyed watching this video. I hope that answers your questions, Alan. Thanks for watching and we'll see you here next time at Scale Me Down.